everything that you consume. More for them, less for you. They do all the sorting, trying to figure out ways to make you feel important while they keep robbing you blind, hold extortion.
In some sense, that's the power of the internet. On the other hand, that's a perfect formula for the dark side.
This is our generation's form of nuclear power. How we deal with this will be the stuff of history.
I roll out with no cash on me, calm now with no mash on me. Stay away from these ashy utes where they come around and get ash on me. That's 5,000 capacity, 5,000 capacity. Then spread that over the UK and then add it up and get back to me. You pussy hoes are not bad for me, madman, they go mad for me. Who the wanna gas you up like you're good enough to be clashing me? Oh, please stop harassing me, charge me up and put gas in me. Them little fish wanna try a ting. Oh man, the audacity. I got girl in my inbox selling me eyes, living on the edge to the end of our lives. Wolf in the sheepskin telling me lies. Sometimes I love when my enemy dies. Woo. So ahead of my time, mainstream way starts letting off.
It is a women's bantamweight showdown between Angela Hill and Alexis Davis. Drillers make killers, and nobody works your takedowns harder than this.
Ready? You ready to fight?
Go. Well, the tension and the buzz is palpable as this fight gets started. Interesting stylistic matchup. Your thoughts on what you might see?
This is a big-time matchup between a fantastic striker and a great all-around mixed martial artist. Both of these women are extremely talented. Let's see who gains the advantage.
Oh, pinpoint placement on the straight punch there. She's got an extended reach advantage in this one and made good use of it there.
Punch over the top. Another clinch position. Nice stick with the right hand.
Landed the overhand.
Nice punch to the head.
Good series of strikes by her there. She is staying wicked busy tonight.
Very busy, but also super accurate. She is on point. Nice job of hiding that head kick.
Oh, man, that's what we call shin on skull. Several times in this fight, she's gone back to the well with that head kick.
She is landing it over and over again, so why would she abandon it? It is such a dominant technical skill that every time she throws it, it lands. She's a great combination striker, and she sets up that high kick as good as anybody we've ever seen.
Oh, she blocks the punch. Swing and a big miss by Hill. It looks like maybe she'll go to the hook here. She does, and she lands.
She throws this punch so efficiently. She has no wasted action on this technique. You can never know what you're going to see with this young lady. Is she going to finish the fight? Beautiful kick.
Now goes in and secures the takedown. Man, she is just nonstop on the ground, moving in all the right directions. Another nice transition by her there.
She's moving a lot, but every movement has purpose.
How good is her movement here on the ground, right? Shades of Ray Borg just transitioning so beautifully.
Yeah, she's so good at transitions and movement. Her ability is unmatched.
Back to the feet now. That knee might have landed there. Another knee by Alexis Davis. Oh, huge hook. Switching stances here.
Liver kick.
20 seconds to go. Hill gets caught with that punch. All right, so she finally gets the takedown. It wasn't for any lack of effort earlier on, but cleaned up the technique a little bit, and now we'll see what she can do.
She cleaned it up. She really did take her time back. She took a step back. She evaluated, what's my best course of action? Figured it out, got it done. Now, how does she handle being on top with dominant top position?
All right, no telestrator for the champ tonight, but that's okay. He'll still talk you through the replays. Body kicks for days, man.
I mean, body kicks for days, but I got to be honest, John. If we don't incorporate a telestrator into this game, this may be my only version of EA UFC.
All right, here we go with our next round. I know you said off the top she might have the best kicking game in this division, and if the previous round is any indication, those words, I think, are pretty true.
John, honestly, watching after that round, it feels like she may have the best kicking game in the whole UFC.
Wow.
Because her opponent has not been able to see or stop any of them. Why would she not continue down this path?
Man, does she throw these hands seamlessly and easily connects with... Well, she told us in our fighter meeting on Thursday the double leg would be there. It was certainly there in that instance.
J.A., she said they're not built like her.
Right.
They can't stand up to the freight train double. And she just got it off. Great job, great technique, great confidence in that position.
Lands a strike now from the bottom. Nice work there by Angela Hill. Oh, well played there as she gets back to her feet. That knee might have landed there. Davis gets hit with a kick. Again, she chooses to clinch here. Oh, beautiful jab. She has certainly found the range with that weapon, and I guess when you have a reach advantage like this, might as well use it. Well, she's got a good jab, missed with it there. Well, she has certainly picked up the pace here in round two and starting to find herself in the pocket a little bit. She was a little bit hesitant in round one.
Great timing on that beautiful takedown.
Well, she was long on grappling experience coming into the UFC, and you see her chops here, just beautiful when it comes to the transition game.
It's very difficult to keep up with her on the ground.
Attempting an armbar here. Nicely done. Oh, nice job by her to posture up there. Now we'll see if she can maintain that separation.
She has to recognize that her opponent will start trying to squirrel away now, but look for her big ground to pound.
Under a minute to go now in round two. While working pretty effectively from the top here. Nice ground and pound by Alexis Davis.
Jump on her back with the overhand.
30 seconds to go in round two. 20 seconds left. Well, pretty good work off of the bottom here by Angela Hill. All right, that's the end of round number two. All right, there's the horn. Let us now check out some of the action from that round, DC. What a display of striking.
Yeah, John, she did a great job. I mean, she knew exactly what she needed to do, and she mixed everything up beautifully, right? Every punch landed to a kick. Whenever her opponent thought kicks, she would follow up with punches. It was a masterclass in striking over the course of that round.
All right, DC, here we go with our next round, and she usually attacks the body well in the lower half, but the head strikes were certainly the storyline there in our previous round.
She likes to mix it up, but when she's having this type of success going to the head, she will take it over and over again And at a point, she's going to sit on something so heavy that she's going to hope to close the show. Nice kick.
Oh, nice land there on the counter punch. She's got an advantage in reach. It's one thing to have it. We always say it's another to put it to good use. She certainly did so there.
See, there it is. She switched.
Oh, she's really using her reach advantage to great effect here tonight. Lands the punch. Oh, man, I'm no strike counter, but that head kick absolutely landed.
That kick got from the floor to her opponent's head before her opponent could react. Clinch. Straight punch lands.
Tries to mix in a takedown here. Nice 1-2 there.
She is such a reverse striker that that big strike landed, and it looks like she's going to finish this fight.
Well, she did not miss a single grappling practice during this training camp, and here's your evidence. Outstanding movement.
Oh! Can't take pictures now. She has to react. She has to go chase the finish.
Well, there are a few things more fun to watch in mixed martial arts than these type of transitions and scrambles on the ground.
High-level grappling can really be entertaining.
Davis is now trying for the Kimura.
Oh, man, that was slick.
Oh, sage work from the bottom here as she tags her with the punch. And she lands that left again. Great movement by her here on the ground, and she just does it so fluidly and so easily. It's really a sight to behold.
You can tell that she's been a lifetime developing this skill with the way that she's able to move with so little effort on the mat.
Man, she is just nonstop on the ground, moving in all the right directions. Another nice transition by her there.
She's moving a lot, but every movement has purpose.
Man, she's got some good ground and pound and putting that part of her game to good use tonight.
She's putting it to great use, just really damaging from the top position.
30 seconds now to go in the fight. 20 seconds now remain in the round. How good is her movement here on the ground, right? Shades of Ray Borg just transitioning so beautifully.
Yeah, she's so good at transitions and movement. Her ability is unmatched.
What else can you say but what a fight? Official decision is now in. It resides with Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards for a decision. Judge one scores the contest, 29-28.
Hill.
Judge two scores it, 28-28. And judge three scores it, 29-28.
For the winner by majority decision, Angela Overkill Hill.
All right, so not her best performance necessarily. She had to wait on those judges' scorecards. Those had to be some harrowing moments, but in the end, majority decision, and she gets a win.
And you could see it on her face how nervous she was. She did not know if she had won this fight. Maybe she was expecting a draw. She did just enough to get her hand raised.
Bantamweight matchup between Tisha Torres and Betch Kohea. Well, drillers make killers, and nobody works her takedowns harder than this young woman. She has become a force in this division, and even though the opposition oftentimes knows what's coming, no one's able to stop that shot.
Nobody's able to stop that takedown attempt. No one's able to stop that single leg. She said in the fighter meetings, I have drilled that takedown 5,000 times.
Amazing.
Over and over, I hit a single leg. Every day of the week, I hit at least 30 single legs. I'm like, well, is wrestling practice every day? She goes, no. I just want to make sure that I have a skill that is so dominant that no matter how much you practice it, you are not practicing it enough to stop me from taking you down with it. It is truly crazy to watch her approach to getting that single leg off.
And her ability to get her opponents off balance in a mixed martial arts setting, as special as anybody in the sport right now. We'll see how it goes for her here tonight. Well, she's about as well-rounded as it gets, DC, and I know you didn't have the benefit of starting as a striker back in the day. First day she stepped in a gym, she was mixing all the different disciplines, and the results certainly speak to that commitment and dedication.
It shows in her ability to fight high-level competition right away. She does not need fights to build her up. She's prepared to fight the wrestler. She's prepared to fight the grappler. She's prepared to do a kickboxing match with the best kickboxer. Her life has prepared her for these moments. All the training, all the sessions, all the private sessions has made her ready to compete for a title right away.
Yeah, I would agree. And at least the early returns are that she looks comfortable and confident in every discipline and every martial arts situation. All right, almost ready to go with this one. Here is tonight's tale of the tape. More than 5 years apart, some differences in height and reach as well. All right, to get us started with the official introductions, here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is 3 rounds in the UFC bantamweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, a kickboxer holding a professional record of 11 wins, 5 losses, and 1 draw. She stands 5 feet 6 inches tall, weighing in at 135 pounds. Fighting out of Campina Grande, Paraíba, Brazil, Betchy Pitbull Correa. And now introducing her opponent, fighting out of the red corner. This woman is a kickboxer holding a professional record of 11 wins, 5 losses. She stands 5 feet 3 inches tall, weighing in at 115 pounds, fighting out of Coconut Creek, Florida, Keisha the Tiny Tornado Torres. And when the action begins, our referee in charge, Herb Dean.
The veteran Herb Dean draws the assignment here.
Ready.
All right, so here we go with round one. Going to be very interesting to see how this plays out stylistically because both women can truly do it all.
This is a very close fight, very competitive fight. Both of these young women are so well-rounded that you can't find an advantage for either fighter. I'm so excited I can barely stay in my seat.
Oh, she lands the punch there, really using her reach advantage in this one thus far.
Nice kick to the right hand.
Well, you can feel that breeze octagon side after the swing and a miss by the Brazilian Betch Correa. Well, she's... Hey, there it is, her first takedown of the fight. She told us in our fighter meeting Thursday, at some point I will take her down. She didn't expect it to take this long.
She really had to work to get this first takedown, and she never gave up on herself. Continued to press, continued to shoot, continued to level change. Now she finally has secured her first takedown.
Oh, nice job by her there to split the guard and land her straight punch.
That punch is so straight and so fast. She's having a difficult time picking up the timing of her opponent's strike.
Oh, big diving punch lands up top. So just over 20 total strikes that have now landed for the Tiny Tornado, Tisha Torres.
Again, in the clinch.
And now she's got the tie clinch.
When you're in the clinch, your beautiful level change leads to the takedown.
Half guard position for her here. And if you're the bottom fighter, this is truly a case of pick your poison.
Yeah, you got to pick your poison. And if you're on the bottom, you got to be trying to find a way to escape that bottom leg. You cannot allow your opponent, you cannot allow her to sit on your leg and just throw big damaging strikes. You've got to make sure you're on an elbow control, an underhook, and getting back to your feet.
Well, Well, she was long on grappling experience coming into the UFC, and you see her chops here, just beautiful when it comes to the transition.
It's very difficult to keep up with her on the ground.
Strong bottom work here, staying busy. Torres gets up and is back on her feet. Very nice. Trying to establish that jab once again.
Big punch to the clinch.
And both fighters exchange in the pocket. Wow. Well, we told you off the top her offensive wrestling was off the charts. She gets another takedown there. Now we'll see what she can do.
Now she looks to try and control her opponent because she's gotten a ton of takedowns, and it's awesome to see. But at some point, she needs to get some ground control if she truly wants to wear down her opponent.
5 minutes in the books. Stop. All right, let's get you some replays from that previous round, DC. I thought she mixed it up beautifully on the feet.
Yes, she did a great job. I mean, she landed everything. She showed a complete example of what her mixed martial arts game has become as she's been in the UFC now for a little bit of time.
All right, listen, you did good that round, but I need you to do a little bit better. I need you to avoid that takedown, okay? Let's not worry about the knees, let's not worry about the striking.
Ready, fight. Ready.
Round two underway.
Nice punch lane.
Pinpoint execution on that straight punch. She's got a reach advantage, and it was pretty obvious in that sequence there. I'm not sure her striking has ever looked better, DC, finding the range with relative ease here tonight.
She's doing a great job of timing everything. She is seeing everything out there.
Circling to her right. Back and forth we go! And she's back in the clinch.
If your opponent has you in the clinch, pulling down on your head, landing punch after punch, you have got to expand.
Oh, there's the double leg takedown. Back to the stand-up now, both fighters upright. Oh, big knee. Now goes in and secures the takedown. Well, she did not miss a single grappling practice during this training camp, and here's your evidence. Outstanding movement on the ground.
She looks like a master of grappling with the great movement that she's showing on the ground.
Kohea gets back up, and pretty quickly, I might add. 65 total strikes have now landed for Tisha Torres. And landing with 55% accuracy against Betch Kohea. Well, she was a little bit...
You can never... what you're going to see with this young lady. Is she going to finish the fight?
Well, that left hand has been there for her tonight. Not on that attempt. Oh! Kohea's lower jaw now is starting to show some signs of swelling. We'll keep an eye on that. But a lot of damage absorbed by me in here tonight.
Another big thing.
With conviction, she moves right into half guard.
Without much effort, she was able to pass from her full guard right into half guard.
Well, there are few things more fun to watch in mixed martial arts than these type of transitions and scrambles on the ground.
High-level grappling can really be entertaining.
Oh, crippling knee to the body! Knee to the body! She blocked the punch.
Left hand punch with the clinch. That was nothing. Nice fight. Right back in the clinch. Look for the back hand to get very active.
20 seconds to go round two. Oh, look at that combination. I got two words for you, champ. Head trauma.
Head trauma, which can be fought by head. Doubly, move your head. Move your head. You want your parents to recognize you by the time the fight is done.
All right, so a lot of strike absorption by her in that previous round. She got stunned on the feet, but survives to see another round. Talk us through the replay, man.
You look at the action here. They're going back and forth, And boom, there goes that big strike that lands that really does hurt her opponent. She could not find the follow-up shot, but eventually she will find that moment.
Ready to fight? Ready.
Good. Third round underway. Can you believe she is able to keep up this output just as she did in the previous round, landing a high volume of strikes here and not slowing down whatsoever? She looks like she could go 10 hard fives if need be tonight. Well, she's so confident in her defense and her ability.
Oh! Nice high kick.
Whoa!
She is such a diverse striker that big strike landed, and it looks like she's going to finish this fight.
Back to the orthodox.
What a takedown.
Correa gets the single leg takedown. Great movement by her here on the ground, and she just does it so fluidly and so easily. It's really a sight to behold.
You can tell that she's been a lifetime developing this skill with the way that she's able to move with so little effort on the mat.
Well, you got to try to stay busy off of your back. She's doing it here. Nice punch. Oh, how about that reversal by her there, champ?
That is a fantastic transition by this young lady. What a job.
3 minutes now to go in the fight. Man, she is just nonstop on the ground, moving in all the right directions. Another nice transition by her there.
She's moving a lot, but every movement has purpose.
Now trying to trap an arm. Done. All right, she postures up here, DC. We'll see if she can get those ground strikes.
Here. Watch for the huge elbows that she's known for.
Well, as usual, suffocating work from the top here by Kohea. It's a beautiful escape and reversal by her there.
Unbelievable sweep. She did a fantastic job of manipulating the weight to change the position.
102 total strikes that have now landed for the tiny tornado, Tisha Torres. And still on the right side of 50%, the land rate 51% here against Betch Kohei. Nice punch there by Torres.
Right hand punch to the clinch.
Now she's got the Muay Thai plum. Thai clinch for her here. We'll see what she can do with it.
Nice kick in the right hand.
When you get in a bad spot on the ground and you want to reverse it, that's what you need to do.
Masterclass in changing position. Unreal to see.
All right, so a nice showcase for both fighters and for this division. Close competitive fight. And now they await the judges' scorecards. Should be interesting.
This is the most uncomfortable situation in all of fighting. Not knowing whether or not you won the fight. But if I could give her something to feel comfortable about, it would be that she was the one that had a slight advantage in the stand-up, and I believe that will get her a victory.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards for a decision. Judge one scores this contest, 29-28.
Kohea.
Judge two scores it, 30-27.
Ora.
And Judge 3 scores it, 9-28.
For the winner by split decision, Tisha the Tiny Tornado Torres.
All right, so a win's a win. She gets it done by split decision. I thought she won the fight and ultimately gets her hand raised.
Yeah, she won the fight, but it was just very, very close, and closer than she thought it would be when she came into this octagon. Credit to her opponent, but also a credit to her for getting through that.
All right, coming up next, it's a UFC Women's Bantamweight Division matchup. She's one of the more well-rounded fighters, DC, that we have in this division. A true mixed martial artist. Her first martial art was MMA. That certainly helps.
Yes, she's a new breed of fighter. A fighter that, as a young girl, she was brought into a gym. And in that gym, she told the coaches, I don't want to wrestle. I don't want to do jiu-jitsu. I don't want to kickbox and box. I want to do it all.
Right.
Is there an MMA class for my daughter to take part in? She did that from day one, and you see all that development over the course of a lifetime has led her to the octagon, where she is already making her impact.
Yeah, she said, I didn't want to get to the UFC until I was 100% comfortable in every situation. So far, so good for her. She's got a big run in front of her here tonight. Well, she's about as well-rounded as it gets, DC, and I know you didn't have the benefit of starting as a striker back in the day. First day she stepped in a gym, she was mixing all the different disciplines, and the results certainly speak to that commitment and dedication.
It shows. It shows in her ability to fight high-level competition right away. She does not need fights to build her up. She's prepared to fight the wrestler. She's prepared to fight the grappler. She's prepared to do a kickboxing match with the best kickboxer. Her life has prepared her for these moments. All the training, all the sessions, all the private sessions has made her ready to compete for a title right away.
Yeah, I would agree. And at least the early returns are that she looks comfortable and confident in every discipline and every martial arts.
You ready? You ready?
Fight. All right, so here we go with round one of this highly anticipated affair. Well-rounded doesn't even begin to describe it. Both women have every skill in the book.
Both of them have every skill in the book. They're so talented. They train so hard. They come from great camp. This is a very even matchup. When you're in a clinch, you can pull down on the head and land these beautiful punches to the head. What a punch.
So the fighters clinch here early, and she has really historically done some of her best work in these type of fighting situations.
Yes, she does a great job of overwhelming you with this clinch position.
Oh! Oh! Oh, really using her reach advantage there with that punch, DC. That's a beautiful jab by her there. We'll see if she can follow it up now.
If you want a beautiful takedown.
There's the single. Well, maybe some panic setting in for her opponent as she continues to land with the ground and pound.
How good is her arm bar? We'll see if she can set it up here.
Nicely done.
Let's go, it's a warning.
Oh, sage work from the bottom here as she tags her with the punch. She's trying to pass here, gets denied.
Got denied because she's so aware, so on top of the grappling transition.
Oh, that's a nice job by her there to reverse the position on the ground.
She was in trouble, now she is the one handing out the punishment. Great change of position, very quickly.
That knee might have landed there.
Beautiful strike. Oh, that was nice.
And potentially a critical takedown here. All right, half guard position for her here. And this is a spot where we've seen her have a lot of wild success in previous fights.
She has a tremendous amount of success with this position because she's so knowledgeable. She keeps the right side underhook and she just goes to work with that. She's posting and elbowing. She's building her posture and punching. There are just so many different ways for her to score strikes from this position.
Seconds now to go in the opening round. Oh, keep it busy here off of her back. Nice offense from the bottom. Final seconds here. Well, you gotta stay busy from the bottom position. Can't falter here. She's doing a nice job. Thank you. right, so that's the end of the round. Lot to like in there, DC, particularly when it comes to her offensive wrestling.
She's evolving, right? She's gotten better. She did not have this skill set before. Now you watch her, and she looks like an Olympian. She looks like a girl that can wrestle at the highest level. She scored so many takedowns in that round. Her wrestling coach must be very proud. Right under the elbow.
Pretty good series of punches by her there. She certainly has found the range early tonight.
She can box with anybody in the world, and she's showing that tonight.
Well, there's no denying her power. She has been pretty accurate here tonight, but she's the type of fighter when she goes to the drive-through window, she's just getting the sandwich. She's not getting the combo meal.
That's embarrassing. That's embarrassing. You're going to go with beautiful takedown land.
With conviction, she moves right into half guard.
Without much effort, she was able to pass from her full guard right into half guard.
How good is her movement here on the ground, right? Shades of Ray Gore just transitioning so beautifully.
Yeah, she's so good at transitions and movement. Her ability is unmatched.
Well, she was long on grappling experience coming into the UFC, and you see her chops here, just beautiful when it comes to the transition.
It's very difficult to keep up with her on the ground.
Well, she did not miss a single grappling practice during this training camp, and here's your evidence. Outstanding movement on the ground.
She looks like a master of grappling. Great movement that she's showing on the ground.
We have now crossed the midpoint of this fight. The ground and pound has been there all night. Oh, and she gives up her back. This is not a fighter going for that patented rear naked choke now.
Oh,
we're getting a finish here.
It's in there deep. There you go.
All right, full guard now, DC. She's on the bottom. What is she trying to do?
Well, she's got to throw up submissions to try to put her opponent on awareness. And these submissions will be used to reverse the position. Even if it gets defended, it will create space for her to try to get back to her feet or maybe to steal a sweep and trick her opponent.
Strong bottom work here, staying busy. All right, she's in full guard here, DC, but you know she passes as well as anybody in this division.
Oh, man, when she gets to the ground, she has an amazing ability. Oh!
Nicely done. Oh, sage work from the bottom here as she tags her with the punch. Third round underway.
Oh, big punch lands. Nice head kick.
Oh, beautiful jab by her there. You know, we referenced her reach advantage on the tail of the tape and certainly made good use of it there.
Can't take many of those. You better check. Real sneaky head kick gets in there. Another big head kick lands. You have got to make some adjustments. Watch knees to the body. Another clinch position.
Oh, she's really starting to put together some significant body shots here, attacking both sides now. DC, for my money, she's really timing her shots pretty well here tonight.
Her timing, accuracy, and also the activity level is great tonight.
Oh, big kick lands flush. Just over 3 minutes to go in round three.
Beautiful body kick.
Well, I'm not sure if she's a former soccer player, but certainly looks like one tonight. Just sheer volume with these kicks, and most of which are landed.
Even when you're kicking, it hurts. It hurts when you kick the elbow. It hurts when it gets checked. It is not deterring this young lady.
Just unable to quite find that range. Well, this is exactly the sense of urgency you'd want to see from her here. She's trying to keep the judges out of it. Really lighten her up now. Well, she lands the strike there, but it is one and done. Dude, she is absolutely cooked.
She's exhausted, J.A. She doesn't have the energy to really throw anything that has any firepower on it. She's done all that she can do early in the fight. It's broken, I think.
Again, back into this position.
How about that shin? Oh, beautifully done there. She lands another strike to the body.
Nice kick.
Well played there as she gets back to her feet.
Great punch. In the tie clinch. Look for the knees to start. Fantastic timing.
Both fighters get up now. Back in the clinch now. Clean with the right hook. Nice liver shot lands. The final horn sounds. All right, so a pretty good showcase for both women here tonight as they go the distance, but there was a striking advantage, I thought, on one side.
Yeah, she had a slight advantage in the striking. She was the one that was able to dictate the exchanges. She was the one that led the dance. She was the one that started them. She didn't stand back and wait, and I believe those moments will allow her to get the victory.
All right, the official decision is now in. Here is Bruce Buffer.
Scorecards for decision. Judge 1 scores the contest, 30-27, Wang. Judge 2 scores it, 9-28, Bulldog. And Judge 3 scores it, 9-28, for the winner by split decision, Wang!
All right, so she gets it done by split decision. We sort of thought that's what we were headed for, that the judges would be split in their opinion. Your thoughts on the decision?
Well, you saw the fight build. You saw the fight build. You saw the ebbs and flow of the fight, and you didn't know who was winning. And when that happens, a lot of times, you don't know...
Coming up next, it's a UFC women's bantamweight division matchup. Well, she's one of the more well-rounded fighters, DC, that we have in this division. A true mixed martial artist. Her first martial art was MMA. That certainly helps.
Yes, she's a new breed of fighter. A fighter that, as a young girl, she was brought into a gym. And in that gym, she told the coaches, I don't want to wrestle. I don't want to do jiu-jitsu. I don't want to kickbox and box. I want to do it all.
Right.
Is there an MMA class for my daughter to take part in? She did that from day one, and you see all that development over the course of a lifetime has led her to the octagon, where she is already making her impact.
Yeah, she said, I didn't want to get to the UFC until I was 100% comfortable in every situation. So far, so good for her. She's got a big one in front of her here tonight. Well, she told us on Thursday she threw her first jab at 4 years old, but she has developed into a well-rounded MMA fighter. All of that said, boxing is still her bread and butter.
Oh, it's unbelievable. At four, she's throwing a jab.
I'm telling you.
Right? We're all talking about our kids learning to ride a bicycle. This young lady was in the gym getting better, learning how to fight under a specific set of rules that carried her all the way up to the UFC. She is a phenomenal fighter, but at the end of the day, it's her boxing that leads the dance. Head's never on the center line. She does a very good job of mixing up the target, goes high, goes low. It's truly amazing to watch someone with such a specified skill set be this successful in mixed martial arts.
Yeah, near perfect technique, which you will see here in a matter of moments.
Ladies and
oh!
All right, so here we go with round one. We're expecting a lot of action and really to see both women challenged in all phases of this match.
They're both so talented. They're both so good at every aspect of fighting. I want to see who can truly force their style on the other one.
Well, clearly she wanted to get this fight to the ground to try to fatigue the striker early. Mission accomplished so far.
Mission accomplished. Even her team couldn't have imagined that it would work so early in the fight. Great timing on that takedown. Right hand punch to the clinch. Over and over. You come up, you go down. Another takedown land.
Going for a submission.
Oh, man, that was slick.
Just over 3 minutes to go round one. Well, there are a few things more fun to watch in mixed martial arts than these type of transitions and scrambles on the ground.
High-level grappling can really be entertaining.
Great movement by her here on the ground, and she just does it so fluidly and so easily. It's really a sight to behold.
You can tell that she's been a lifetime developing this skill with the way that she's able to move with so little effort on the mat.
That reversal by her there, Jim.
That is a fantastic transition by this young lady. What a job.
Well, she's able to connect on the punch there, DC, really making good use of her reach advantage. Changes her stance. Back to orthodox. Well, she's been good tonight, but she missed without.
Right hand punch from the clinch. Big punch from the clinch.
Well, she's already landed several big takedowns, and there's another one. So you got to like what you're seeing here. This offensive wrestling is on point.
It's unbelievable, the variety of takedowns is what I am truly a fan of. It's not just one thing. She is doing different approaches, different takedowns.
Oh, looks like she's got the arm. This could be trouble. Man, she is just nonstop on the ground, moving in all the right directions. Another nice transition by her there.
She's moving a lot, but every movement has purpose.
Round two straight ahead. A lot of tremendous striking action in that last round, DC. I know you don't have a telestrator, but take us through the replay.
I mean, I would love to have my telestrator right now. That was a great display of high-level mixed martial arts striking. Both combatants stood toe-to-toe and let it all hang out.
All right, round two.
Nice kick with the right hand.
Oh, she is wearing it. Bleeding from her cheek now.
Oh, massive knee lands from Ty Clinch.
Oh, now she...
Oh, John, that was so nice. What a beautiful takedown.
How good is her movement here on the ground, right? Shades of Ray Borg just transitioning so beautifully.
Yeah, she's so good at transitions and movement. Her ability is unmatched.
Going for an arm bar now. Oh, nice job by her.
Oh, man, that was slick.
We have crossed the midpoint of this one. Well, you got to try to stay busy off of your back. She's doing it here. Nice punch. Well, she connects with a right hand. She loves that right hand, and why not?
It's her best punch, and if her opponent doesn't change something, she's going to go to sleep.
Oh, keeping busy here off of her back. Nice offense from the bottom. All right, so she's able to work her way back to her feet now. Well, she has certainly picked up the pace here in round two and started to find herself in the pocket a little bit. She was a little bit hesitant in round one. Whoa!
Can't take pictures now. She has to react. She has to go chase the finish.
All right, so another swing and a miss, and I'd imagine if your gas tank is this low, you got to find times to try to preserve that energy and get yourself back to a place where you can actually dole out some damage.
Yeah, you got to get out of space. Find places to rest and recover. Get against the octagon. Go to the clinch. Find ways to just recover so that when you have that next explosion, it actually has some meaning to it. Right hand punch to the clinch.
20 seconds left.
Big kick land.
10 seconds to go. Round three next. Right now, we take a look back at some of the action in that previous round, DC. A lot to like on both sides, really.
I mean, both were intent on going forward. And what happens when nobody wants to take a step back? They meet in the middle. That's true.
All right, so here we go. Third and final round. Oh, she continues to land a high number of strikes here, just like she did in the previous round. It's one thing to be aggressive, but also efficient. She is certainly doing that. Well, we told you off the top, she's got the longer reach and certainly made good use of it in landing that straight punch there.
Big kick.
And she switches to southpaw.
Takedown range.
Oh, and with conviction, she moves right into half guard.
Without much effort, she was able to pass from her full guard right into half guard.
Well, you gotta stay busy from the bottom position. Can't falter here. She's doing a nice job. Just over 3 minutes to go in round three. Well, she was long on grappling experience coming into the UFC, and you see her chops here. Just beautiful when it comes to the transition.
It's very difficult to keep up with her on the ground.
There it is.
Nice job by her, but nicely done. Oh, she gives up her back here. So a case of pick your poison, and now she's going to have to work hard defensively to prevent the finish.
Well, she's got to protect her neck. That's the first thing. She's got to really be aware of where her opponent's arms are. If her opponents get anywhere near her neck, she needs to really defend. Attack the top hand. The top hand is the choke hand. Make sure that top hand is always yours. When you grab it, keep it. It belongs to you now. And you start to work, try to get to your base and get back to your feet.
Strong bottom work here, staying busy. All right, stacked guard here, DC. She's got the feet on the hips if she wants to escape.
Yeah, she's free. I mean, she's free. Once you get your feet on the hips, you're free. And she has done that. She has beaten the position. All she has to do now is extend her opponent away from her, kick her off, post her hand on the mat, just basic jiu-jitsu stand-up to get right back to fighting on her feet.
Oh, sage work from the bottom here as she tags her with the punch. Back to her feet now. Good sign for her there. Well, you got to try to stay busy off of your back. She's doing it here. Nice punch. All right, so the fight was close according to Las Vegas. It was competitive throughout. We might be destined for a split decision.
I mean, this is exactly what we expected this fight to be. You knew that you were about to watch two of the best female fighters in the entire world. She held a slight advantage on the stand-up, and I think that's going to be enough to earn her a victory.
All right, the official decision is now in. Here is Bruce
Buff. The judges' scorecards for decision. Judge 1 scores this contest, 29-28, Rodriguez. Judge 2 scores it, 9-28, Roberts. And Judge 3 scores it, 9-28.
For the winner by split decision, Roberts!
Well, the win's a win, DC. Doesn't matter how it goes into the books. She gets it done by split decision tonight. Nothing easy, though, about standing there waiting for the judges to render their scorecards.
Well, I mean, and then you become uncertain.
It is a women's bantamweight matchup between Michelle Waterson and Felice Herrig. Well, she's about as well-rounded as it gets, DC, and I know you didn't have the benefit of...
You ready?
All right, so here we go with round one. Going to be very interesting to see how this plays out stylistically because both women can truly do it all.
This is a very close fight, very competitive fight. Both of these young women are so well-rounded that you can't find an advantage for either fighter. I'm so excited I can barely stay in my seat.
Well, she's got the longer reach. No problem finding her range and landing the straight punch there. All right, she postures up here, DC. We'll see if she can get those ground strikes.
Watch for the huge elbows that she's known for.
Fighters back to their feet here. Oh, keep it busy here off of her back. Nice offense from the bottom. Herrig's trying for the Kimura submission here.
Oh, man, that was slick.
Well, hard to win fights in mixed martial arts from the bottom, but nice work here in that position by Herrig.
Nice stick with the right hand.
Back to the feet now. A swing and a miss by Herrig. Watterson's hook shot blocked. That one was telegraphed. Good job by the defense.
Oh, clinch position. Watch the knees and the elbows come now.
Just out of range with that right hook. Oh, pretty good knee to the body by her there. It seemed as though her opponent just didn't see that strike coming.
She didn't see the knee coming, and she paid for it.
Nice punch there by Herrig. So just over 20 total strikes that have now landed for the karate hottie Michelle Waterson. Oh, big head kick there.
Oh, that was a really nice takedown.
Well, she did not miss a single grappling practice during this training camp, and here's your evidence. Outstanding move. Herrig's looking for that arm triangle now. More fun to watch in mixed martial arts than these type of transitions and scrambles on the ground.
High-level grappling can really be entertaining. I mean, look at the commitment to kicking in these fights.
Waterson's hook shot is blocked. Saw that coming from a mile away.
If your opponent has you in the clinch, pull it down on your head, landing punch after punch, you have got to clear that collar tie, reach back inside, and find space.
right, let's take a look back at some of the replays. You knew she came in with the book on her as a kicker, and her opponent did nothing to adjust.
Her opponent didn't check one kick. So why would she not continue down that path? Why would she not continue to throw her hands just to set up those beautiful, nasty kicks? And she is landing them with full force every time she throws it.
You ready?
All right, here we go with round two. Nice 1-2 there. Oh, big kick four there.
Those are big strikes.
Well, you hate to be overly critical because she has landed some good shots, but really nothing in terms of combinations tonight.
She's got to let it fly, man. She needs to let the combinations fly. She's got to find the confidence knowing that all that repetition, all that work for her boxing coach is going to pay dividends inside of the octagon.
Great tempo to her striking game tonight. She is staying busy and a nice series of punches again there.
She's in a great flow state. The hands are flowing, the head movement's going. She's doing a fantastic job.
You love that flow state.
I love it.
Well, you saw us reference that reach advantage off the top, and she certainly made good use of it there in landing that punch.
Big kick land.
Herrig's lower jaw now is starting to show some signs of swelling. We'll keep an eye on that, but a lot of damage absorbed by Meehan here tonight. Nice land there with the right punch. Easy to see why that is her weapon of choice.
Great right hand. Nice land.
So 57 total strikes that have now landed for the karate hottie Michelle Waterson. And connecting with 48% accuracy. Nice job to stick with it there to complete the takedown. She moves right into half guard.
Without much effort, she was able to pass from her full guard right into half guard.
Herrig's looking to lock up an arm bar here.
There it is. I got the arm
bar. Oh, nice job,
buddy. Oh, man, that was slick.
Seconds now remain in the round. All right, so her ground control is outstanding. Half guard is when she's at her most dangerous.
Yes, she's at her most dangerous when she has the half guard because she's so brutal with the grounded pound. She likes to go after fighters and really wear on them, force them to make decisions to give their backs so that she can chase her submissions, or they're going to lay on their back and just get beaten up from the top from that beautiful half guard position.
Full escape and reversal by her there.
Unbelievable sweep. She did a fantastic job of manipulating the weight to change the position.
Final seconds. Two rounds in the books. All right, so what a round it was, DC. Take us through some of the highlights. Got to think her kicking game is going to be featured prominently here.
She did decent work with the hands, but the kicking game was the thing that truly separated her from her opponent. She was landing kick after kick and truly slowing down her opponent in that round.
All right, here we go. Next round is underway, and how about her kicking game in the previous round? My lord.
She is so good at just blasting kicks with no regard for what's coming back at her. She's not worried about the counter. She will check a reverse kick. She always moves her head off the center line when she throws kicks, so she is not in any danger of taking a counter right hand.
Shooting for the takedown here. Oh, really using her reach advantage to land the jab there, DC.
Big head kick land.
Well, she lands another strike to the body here, and the percentage is getting high now in terms of the body strikes landed. Didn't see a lot of that earlier on, making up for lost time here. 70 total strikes that have now landed for the karate hottie Michelle Waters. Well, hitting on one out of every two, landing with 50% accuracy tonight against Felice Herrig. Again, they will clinch. We'll see how it goes.
Level change, the leg, finish the takedown. Great job.
Oh, and with conviction, she moves right into half guard.
Without much effort, she was able to pass from her full guard right into half guard.
Oh, going for the arm bar now. That might be tight. Nicely done.
Let's go, let's go. It's a warning.
Just reached the midway point of the fight. Well, you gotta stay busy from the bottom position. Can't falter here. She's doing a nice job. All right, 2 minutes now to go in the round. Great movement by her here on the ground, and she just does it so fluidly and so easily. It's really a sight to behold.
You can tell that she's been a lifetime developing this skill with the way that she's able to move with so little effort on the mat.
Oh, nice job by her to posture up there. Now we'll see if she can maintain that separation.
She has to recognize that her opponent will start trying to squirrel away now, but look for her big ground to come.
All right, she's got north-south position now, DC. We don't see a lot of north-south chokes in the UFC, but what is she trying to do here from what is a dominant position?
Well, you know, the north-south choke is very difficult because everybody is so well-versed in submission defense now.
Right.
But if done the correct way, it can happen. But you hit that north-south choke, hope that your opponent turns to their knees so that you can run to the back, try to get your hooks in, or you can attack guillotine when they go to their knees.
Let us now check out some of the action from that round, DC, and what a display of striking for her.
Yeah.
You ready?
Fourth round, fight scheduled for 5 5-minute rounds. Nice punch by Harry. Right on the button.
Another good stick to the head.
She works the body as well as anybody in this division. Another strike there, and these shots are really going to take their toll as this fight moves on. Whoa!
You can never know what you're going to see with this young lady. Is she going to finish the fight?
So she holds on to her fear, not doing too much, really just looking to recover.
Oh!
Now, Owen, a quick entry.
Great single entry. Rotates the high punch, taking for a ride.
Man, she is just nonstop on the ground, moving in all the right directions. Another nice transition by her, though.
She's moving a lot, but every movement has purpose.
And she switches to southpaw. Whoa!
She is such a diverse striker that big strike landed, and it looks like she's going to finish this fight.
Well, she's got nothing left in the tank, and there's another just huge whiff. Forgettable effort, at least in terms of the cardio, I think.
Yeah, she's done. She's so tired that she's going for the head, but the head's never...
Harry gets the double leg takedown. How good is her movement here on the ground, right? Shades of Ray Borg just transitioning.
She heard about it.
Gets up again here, but hurts. Now she's got the Muay Thai club.
You get up. Go down as another takedown tip lands.
Well, she was long on grappling experience coming into the UFC, and you see her chops here. Just beautiful when it comes to the transition.
It's very difficult to keep up with her on the ground.
Lands a strike now from the bottom. Nice work there by Watterson. Final minute to go here in round four. Well, pretty good work off of the bottom here by the Karate Hottie. Herrigs has got full mount now. She's going. going for the arm bar here.
Attacking arm bar.
Archie postures up here.
Oh, man, that was slick.
And there's the buzzer indicating the end of round four. Fifth and final round.
Big punch lands through the middle.
Nice jab, follows it up with a nice right hand. Well, she continues to stay busy, and no surprise, she continues to connect with these punches.
She's so fast and so accurate, and also the cardio allows her to fight at such a great pace. More clinching. When you're in a clinch, you can pull down with the head and land beautiful punches to the head.
Half guard position for her here, and if you're the bottom fighter, this is truly a case of pick your poison.
Yeah, you gotta pick your poison. And if you're on the bottom, you gotta be trying to find a way to escape that bottom leg. You cannot allow your opponent, you cannot allow her to sit on your leg and just throw big damage and strikes. You've got to make sure you're on an elbow control, an underhook, and getting back to your feet.
So when you get in a bad spot on the ground and you wanna reverse it, that's what you need to do.
Masterclass in changing position. Unreal to see.
Just over 3 minutes now to go in the fight. Nicely done. Strong bottom work here. Staying busy. Well, she did not miss a single grappling practice during this training camp, and here's your evidence. Outstanding movement on the ground.
She looks like a master of grappling. And great movement that she's showing on the ground.
Herrick's lower jaw is just nasty at this point. Really swollen in that area now. That's a nice job by her there to reverse the position on the ground.
She was in trouble. Now she is the one handing out the punishment. Great change of position very quickly.
Oh, she's going for a submission attempt now. Under 1 minute remains in round five. And they both stand up. Wow, is she applying a lot of pressure here? I'm not sure how much her opponent can take. Clear sense of urgency here as she tries to make sure the judges stay out of it.
What a tricky head kick.
Oh!
Can't take pictures now. She has to react. She has to go chase the finish.
Official decision now in, the Buff has it.
Ladies and gentlemen, after five rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards for a decision. Judge 1 scores this contest 47-47. Judge 2 scores it 48-46.
Herrick.
And Judge 3 scores it 48-46.
For the winner by majority decision, Felice Wilbuka Herrick.
All right, so a lot of close rounds, a lot of close moments within those rounds. a women's bantamweight matchup between Ronda Rousey and Joanna Jędrzejczyk. All right, here is Poland's best, Joanna Jędrzejczyk. She really is the total package, Daniel Cormier, as a fighter inside the octagon and as an intimidator outside of it. I mean, that stare down will cut a man like me right down.
Oh, it's unbelievable, John. I mean, just the mind games that Joanna can play on her opponents is unreal. Every time I think about how she tortured Carla Esparza leading into her first UFC championship fight. It seemed as though Esparza just wanted to be done with it by the time the whole thing was over. But you can only talk so much. Ultimately, you have to back it up, and Joanna Jędrzejczyk sure can back it up.
Arguably the most dominant champion the women's game has ever seen. Enter former UFC Women's Bantamweight Champion, Rowdy Ronda Rousey.
Just the biggest star in MMA up to Conor McGregor coming here, taking over. Ronda Rousey was just truly, truly something special. Ronda Rousey was just one of the biggest stars mixed martial arts has ever seen. From the debut in Strikeforce with the quick armbar to Jean LaBelle holding a stopwatch every time she fought.
Yeah.
She just had that star appeal, and she had enough to share. She didn't need to use it all on herself. She could give something to me, she could give something to this guy, yeah, this guy, this guy, this guy. And there was enough. A massive fight star, a massive movie star, just a mainstream star is Ronda Rousey.
All right, just about ready for live action. Here is tonight's tale of the tape. 4 years apart, some differences in height and reach. Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event.
All right, so here we go with round one of this highly anticipated affair. Well-rounded, doesn't even begin to describe it. Both women have every skill in the book.
Both of them have every skill in the book. They're so talented. They train so hard. They come from great camp. This is a very even match.
Well, there are a few things more fun to watch in mixed martial arts than these type of transitions and scrambles on the ground.
High-level grappling can really be entertaining.
Both fighters back to their feet now. That knee might have landed there. And there comes the separation now. Oh, huge kick to that lead leg.
Oh!
Oh, big left hook there.
What a body kick.
She lands the punch there. You know, it's one thing to have an edge in reach. It's another thing to take advantage. Nicely done by her there.
Sneaky head kick. Nice punch lands over the top.
Well, she's really putting it all together on the feet, DC. Staying busy and certainly staying accurate.
She's known for her hands, and this is why. Left hand punch to the clinch.
So just over 20 total strikes have now landed for Joanna Jędrzejczyk.
Nice take.
And there it is. So her best entry, I think, in terms of the offensive wrestling and the takedown attempts, finally gets her opponent down for the first time.
It feels like she gave up on getting the takedown, so it started to flow more naturally.
Right.
She was not forcing her entries anymore. Just let it come to her, and now she's got the takedown to speak for.
Jędrzejczyk's got the full mount. We'll see if she can set up the armbar now. Nicely done. Oh, nice job by her there. You see how strong she is. Her opponent's trying to control posture, unable to do so.
Now she can get to work and put the money in the bank with that ground and pound.
Money in the bank.
That is a fantastic transition by this young lady. What a job.
Rousey's in half guard. Oh, how good was that right hand? Beautiful connection by her there.
Right down the pipe, right on the chin.
Oh, sage work from the bottom here as she tags her with the punch. Well, you got to try to stay busy off of your back. She's doing it here. Nice punch. Young Jacek's looking for an arm bar. Oh, saved by the bell. Round over. And the finish came just in time. Thought maybe she might tap there, but you know how tough she is. So the submission attempt right at the end of the round.
You ready?
Second round underway. 1-2 punch by Ronda Rousey. Oh, and she connects there, so the hands look good tonight.
Great time to land that punch.
Oh, double leg lands. Rousey gets up and is back on her feet. Very nice.
Look at the control of the posture as they land that knee.
Judo toss is good. Takedown landed now by Yeon Jae-chul. Nice job by her to posture up there. Now we'll see if she can maintain that separation.
She has to recognize it.
All right, she's going for the armbar here. Nicely done. Well, the ground and pound is there once again. Strong work here by Yeon Jae-chul. All right, she postures up here, DC. We'll see if she can get those ground strikes.
Watch for the huge elbows that she's known for.
Well, her opponent is squirming, and this might be the beginning of the end. The ground and pound strikes continue to land at will.
She's landing it over and over again. To make sure that once she's chasing the finish, she doesn't get excited and lose the position.
Try to establish that jab. Well, she was a little bit hesitant in round one, but she has certainly picked up the pace here in the second round. It took her a while to find her range. She's in a strong striking rhythm now.
I think she heard it.
Oh, she blocked the punch. Jacek's lower jaw does not look good. I don't think it's broken, but starting to show some obvious signs of swelling.
Look at the turtles in that kick.
Oh, big elbow. Now goes in and secures the takedown. With conviction, she moves right into half guard.
Without much effort, she was able to pass from her full guard right into half guard.
Back to the feet now.
Big leg kick land.
Yeon Jae-chul gets caught with that punch. Don't be afraid to get that head off the center line. Final seconds here of round number two. Well-timed overhand there by Ronda Rousey. Let's check out some of the action in that previous round. DC, she certainly kept the stat trackers busy with all those takedowns.
All those takedowns and some really nice takedowns. She did a great job of level changing, getting into her opponent, not allowing her opponent to defend before she could secure her takedown.
All right, well, she made the takedown a thing of beauty in that first round. We'll see if she can pick up where she left off.
And she has to, because if she is forced to stand here, she's going to have a very difficult long fight. When she is able to secure takedowns, whether it's a high cross, whether it's a single, or even from the clinch, she's able to get takedowns in so many different ways. They all lead to her being in a dominant position where she's comfortable.
Nice job by her to land the straight punch yet again. You know she's got the reach advantage, and she is making sure it counts in this matchup tonight. Oh, she just continues to land a high volume of strikes here, really just like she did in the previous round, and she does not seem to be slowing down at all. Well, she's been good tonight, but she missed with that one. All right, so once again, they will clinch, and we will see which fighter is able to advance their position from here.
Who's going to be the first one to attempt the takedown? Both of our combatants have the ability to score and secure the position. Who's going to be the one that makes the first move? She lands a switch knee.
And they separate. Back and forth we go here. 1-2 there by Rousey. Oh, good series of punches by her there.
She's in her zone. She's flowing right now. Big kick land.
Well, how urgent is this fighter down the stretch? She is really lighting her up now. She found her range in the middle of this fight, and she is making up for lost time. Oh, and she gets the takedown. Just over 2 minutes now to go. Great movement by her here on the ground, and she just does it so fluidly and so easily. It's really a sight to behold.
You can tell that she's been a lifetime developing this skill with the way that she's able to move with so little effort on the mat.
Man, she is just nonstop on the ground, moving in all the right directions. Another nice transition by her.
She's moving a lot with every movement.
Jack's got her head going to the guillotine now. Nicely done. Strong bottom work here, staying busy. Seconds remain in the round. Oh, that's a beautiful escape and reversal by her there.
Unbelievable sweep. She did a fantastic job of manipulating the weight to change the position.
10 seconds. And that'll do it. 15 minutes in the books. Let's get you some highlights from that previous round.
You ready? You ready?
Fourth round now. Fight scheduled for 5 5-minute rounds.
Good punch.
You know, Jacek's lower jaw does not look good. I'm not sure it could be any more swollen. She continues to fight through it. Let's see how far she can go.
Nice kick with the right hand.
Looping left hand misses the target. Yeon Jacek gets in the clinch here, and she is absolutely a monster.
Come on, let's go, do something.
What a wrestler. That was an amazing takedown.
Back to the stand-up now, both fighters upright. That knee might have landed there. And she lands.
Oh! You can never know what you're going to see if this young lady, is she going to finish the fight?
Oh! Oh, pinpoint jab placement there, and a nice job to take advantage of her edge and reach. Oh, hook to the head by Rousey. She blocked the punch. All right, she's landed some pretty good shots here tonight, but still DC unable to string any solid combinations together.
I just don't believe she's confident in being in there. She's very aware of her opponent's power, so it's making her limit her activity on the inside. Throw that out the window. You're the faster fighter. You're successful. Let those combinations string together.
You know, Jacek gets in the clinch here. Let's see what she can do with it.
Dig and kick.
Oh, she blocks the punch.
Put your hands up higher.
90 seconds to go.
Fantastic takedown land.
How good is her movement here on the ground, right? Shades of Ray Borg just transitioning so beautifully.
Yeah, she's so good at transitions and movement. Her ability is unmatched. Look at that great work to the body from the clinch. Oh! She is such a diverse striker that that big strike landed, and it looks like she's going to finish his fight.
Oh. That is it! Yeah, that was just a beautiful shot by her there to end the fight. I'm not sure she could have drawn it up any better than it played out here tonight. She lands the seminal blow there midway through the round. I'm not even sure her opponent saw it coming. So big, big knockout win for her here tonight. All right, we take a look back at some of the pictures from this one, and she had it all going on tonight, but certainly her boxing was on point.
Her boxing...
The official decision is in. Here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Eve Levine has called a stop to this contest at 4 minutes, 30
is a women's bantamweight showdown between Jermaine Durandamy and Chris Cyborg. All right, here's one of the best to ever do it. Chris Cyborg, the former UFC women's featherweight champion, and her focus is entirely on getting that belt back. Tonight figures to be another step in that direction.
I've never seen anyone more dominant, regardless of men, women. Chris Cyborg had an ability to make people just quit. The power, the aggressiveness, the ability to get in your face, make you work and make you uncomfortable is second to none. She is such a dominant physical presence that most people are beaten before they even step in the octagon.
She finally stepped into the octagon for the first time in 2016, won 5 consecutive fights, including the world title, before running into Amanda Nunes. Chris Cyborg, though, back tonight and a picture of focus in advance of this one. All right, so here she is, the decorated kickboxer, back for another run here in the UFC. Such a wide, vast array of kicks and punches in her arsenal, but it all comes back to elite technique.
Oh, yeah, she has phenomenal technique. There is no wasted action. What I really love is the left hook. She does a great job of throwing her left hook behind her right hand. She throws the right hand, and the left hook follows. It's always so tight. It's always so clean. And then outside leg kick. Every combination ends with a kick. When you think it's over, she's putting one more technique, one more opportunity to put some damage on you before you get to go back to space and go back to the safety of her out of your face, which will only last for a short period of time.
She certainly has a crowd-pleasing style. No surprise to see her.
You ready? Are you ready?
All right, so here we go with round one. We're expecting a lot of action and really to see both women challenged in all phases of mixed martial arts.
They're both so talented. They're both so good at every aspect of fighting. I want to see who can truly force their style on the other one.
Oh, she's really using her reach advantage to great effect here tonight. Lands the punch.
Again, back into this position.
Oh! Superman punch lands! And she misses with the left punch there.
Great punch landing with so much power.
And she lands the knee to the body now. All right, so a nice job there defensively to raise the guard and prevent any damage.
Those hands never leave where they're supposed to be.
Oh, and there's that double leg takedown. She's got one of the best arm bars in the business going for it now. Nicely done. Well, pretty good work off of the bottom here by Cyborg. Under 3 minutes now to go in the round. Well, hard to win fights in mixed martial arts from the bottom, but nice work here in that position by Cyborg. Well, she was long on grappling experience coming into the UFC, and you see her chops here, just beautiful when it comes to the transition game.
It's very difficult to keep up with her on the ground.
So just over 20 total strikes have landed for Jermaine Durand.
Big kick land.
Oh, you know about her kick. She's got him going tonight. Mixes it up nicely in terms of staying heavy and also staying active. Cyborg's lower jaw now is starting to show some signs of swelling. We'll keep an eye on that. But a lot of damage absorbed by Mia here tonight. Oh, she landed another hook there. She's already landed several here in this round. I think the kids would probably say her striking is clean.
Tonight. It's very, very clean the way that she pivots off of her first punch and then twists into that hook. And you see it damaging her opponent.
It's got to do something.
Nice straight punch.
Under a minute now to go in the round, and finally she gets the takedown. She stayed committed. At some point, she knew she was going to be able to get this fight in her wheelhouse on the canvas. Now let's see what she can do with it. Fighters back to their feet here. Big power shot there.
Right hand.
Come on, let's go. Do something.
Man, her striking looks clean tonight. Timing on point.
Her timing on point. Her accuracy's on point. She's very busy. She's in a good flow. What a big-time takedown.
In a very close round, a takedown like that might be the difference.
All right, so we now look back at some of the action from that previous round, DC. A lot of good highlights on both sides.
I mean, a lot of good highlights from both competitors. They both should be very proud of what they accomplished. But I'm telling you, man, I'm not sure they can keep this up. If they land at this clip for another 5 minutes, somebody's going to sleep.
All right, here we go. Round two is now underway. Round one had its moments. Not the round of the year necessarily, but your thoughts on these two women and what they did in round one.
Both of them had success. They both found their spots where they had moments, but nothing was sustained. Let's see who can really dominate the fight going forward.
All right, new round, same storyline. She continues to land that hook of hers much like she did in the previous round. And if her opponent doesn't adjust here quickly, this fight's going to be over.
New round, same story. Left hook, right hook, body hook, body hook. She's doing everything and landing wherever she wants with her very best punch.
All right, so again, the fighters clinched here. Kind of had an inkling we'd find ourselves back in this situation.
Absolutely. Both of these fighters love fighting chest to chest. The uglier the fight, the better.
Oh, pinpoint placement on the straight punch there. She's got an extended reach advantage in this one and made good use of it there. Oh, and with conviction, she moves right into half guard.
Without much effort, she was able to pass from her full guard right into half guard.
Oh, nice job by her there. You see how strong she is. Her opponent's trying to control posture, unable to do so.
Now she can get to work and put the money in the bank with that ground and pound.
Money in the bank. Attempting an arm bar here. Oh, nice job by her to pop.
Oh, man, that was slick.
Her ground and pound is downright scary. In constant pursuit of the finish, might get it.
She does a really good job of throwing punches with intent. She never just throws just to be thrown. Every punch is meant to land. Every punch is meant to start a finish.
They continue to exchange. Swing and a miss by Durandamy. Well, she has certainly picked up the pace here in round two and starting to find herself in the pocket a little bit. She was a little bit hesitant in round one. No hesitancy whatsoever here in round two. She has clearly found her rhythm and range. Timing her shots nicely here tonight, DC.
She's doing beautiful takedown in first lane.
Final minute. Well, she did not miss a single grappling practice during this training camp, and here's your evidence. Outstanding movement on the ground.
She looks like a master of grappling with the great movement that she's showing on the ground.
Oh!
Things are bad. Can't take pictures now. She has to react. She has to move chase to finish.
Back to the feet. to land him. Oh! Cyborg's lower jaw. Entertaining scrap so far. All right, so we will see another round here. Sat her opponent down there in that previous round with a punch.
Surprisingly, we are going forward because I thought it was over. I saw that punch land. We started to yell. We started to scream. We thought the fight was done, but we moved forward because her opponent is so tough, but she's so skilled that she can't get there again.
All right, so two pretty good previous rounds. Now another round is underway. Your thoughts on what we might see here over these 5 minutes?
That one of these young ladies will really start to try and drive the point home that she is the better fighter.
Well, how impressive is this young woman? High volume of strikes in the previous round and picking up exactly where she left off here and not really showing.
Whoa! You can never know what you're going to see with this young lady. Is she going to finish the fight?
Whoa! Durandamy gets up and is back on her feet. Very nice.
That knee might have landed there.
Oh, now she's got that tie clinch. Appreciable damage could be coming.
You need
Cyborg
to get out
gets
there.
Caught
Let's
with that.
Do something.
Oh, she connected with the knee of the body there. And this is something she saw on film. Her opponent left that body open. And she barged right through that hook.
She's taking advantage of a weakness, and she'll look to continue doing the same thing. She is such a diverse striker that Dash Big Strike landed, and it looks like she's going to finish
That'll
the fight.
That'll do it! A good stoppage by the referee. She was not effectively defending herself, and the opponent was doing some real damage. It became a dangerous situation. I think it's the right call by the official, and she will live to fight another day. All right, we take a look back at some of the pictures from this one, and she had it all going on tonight, but certainly her boxing was on point.
Her boxing always is what allows her to dictate the pace of fights. Finally, she landed the strike that ended the night of her opponent.
Here once more, Bruce Buff.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Eve Levine called a stop to this contest at 2:01 of the third round. Declaring the winner by knockout, Jermaine the Iron Lady, Durandamy.